Next, we will see the different representation for the frequency distribution. So first two diagram is represented by only non-frequency data. Okay, now for frequency distribution there are many form, okay, many diagrammatic presentation is given. We will explain three diagram. First is frequency polygon, second histogram, and third is ogive or ogive jab. Okay, so first is frequency distribution, frequency polygon for a frequency distribution. Now frequency polygon is used for the discrete variables. Okay, as the frequency distribution has two frequency distribution is represents two data, one is discrete variable and second is continuous variable. Now for discrete variable data there is only one distribution, which is simple frequency distribution. So for simple frequency distribution we will draw a or represents a graph which will be represented the frequency distribution, a frequency polygon, sorry. So frequency polygon. Now we all know the polygon is a diagram, is a closed diagram which have many sides. Okay, or in other word, the closed figure which have more than two sides is called a polygon, as there will be no closed diagram which have only two sides. Okay, so as an example, the triangle is a three-sided polygon, the quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon, the pentagon is a five-sided polygon. Okay, so as we said, this is a frequency polygon, so there will be a closed polygon. So I will get a closed polygon for a frequency frequency distribution for a discrete variable. Okay, as we know, the frequency distribution is given as, let's set an example, the frequency distribution can be given in the form, so first is x and this is f. X is the values and f is the corresponding frequencies. So we take the frequency the values as in this form 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, and 5, let's 5, and frequency is the corresponding frequencies for 1 is, let's say, 5, for 2 this 3, for 3 let's say 4, for 4 the frequency be 5, and for 5 the frequency, let's see, 2. Okay, now so if we form a points for this frequency distribution, so first point will be 1,5. Now this one represents the value and that this is represent the corresponding frequencies. Then the remaining part will be 2,4 2,3 3,4 4,5 and 5,2. Now so there are total 1 2 3 4 5 points. Now if we put these points in a graph, okay, unit graph, the graph which have two axes, this is origin, okay, this is origin. So now first direction, the x direction represents the values. Okay, so the values of a family or values of a category. Now second axis represents the frequency. Okay, so we will get, we will first form the unit size in each direction. is this slice represents the unit value. Okay, now first is values. So for the first point, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this will be 1,5. Now second for 1, second 2, this will be 2,3. Okay, this will be 2,3. Next 3,4, 3,4, 1,2,3,4. Sorry, this will be this point 1,5. So this 3,4, this will be the third point. Okay, corresponding to the value 3, and corresponding to the value 4, this will be this point. Okay, corresponding to this. Now lastly, the fifth point, which will be this 2. Okay, this is 2. So we will get, now by joining this point, we will get a polygon. Now, not a polygon, but a graph. Okay, graph, but this is not a closed graph. So make it close, we will add the first point, which will be 0 0, as the gm, the values, when the values is 0, the frequencies is 0, and lastly, as there is no values corresponding, there is no frequency corresponding to the value 6, we can take this point 6,0. Okay, so 0 0, this point, and 6,0, this point. So we will add these two point. So we will get a closed polygon. This is the total closed polygon. Okay, this point is 2,3, this point is 3,4, this point is 4,5, this point is 6,0, and this is 0 0. In this way, we will get a polygon, closed polygon. Okay, so this represents the frequency polygon corresponding to the given frequency distribution. So this graph is from or represents the frequency distribution. Okay, so for a given if you have to find a frequency polygon for a given data, so you will first form the given values and points, given values and frequency as the points form, and then we add the last and first points as the is in the values, whose values is 0, and the first frequency is 0, and next frequency you can take any form. If there is a relation in the values, so you will take the next values. Okay. Now next is histogram. Next representation of data is histogram. Histogram. Now, the frequency polygon is used only on the discrete values, that is only on the simple frequency distribution. But histogram is used, as you can see, if there is a group in the values, then we cannot find a given points, we cannot calculate it as in the points form. So for a group frequency distribution, we will use the next diagrammatic presentation, which is histogram. As we know, frequency distribution, group frequency distribution is used only on continuous variable. So this is for a continuous variable representation. Okay. Now, to calculate or to draw a histogram, first we have to learn the frequency density. Okay, what is frequency density? Now group frequency, group frequency distribution has a has their values in the interval form. Okay, there is a lower boundary, there is a upper boundary. Okay, so the frequency density will be frequency density will be equals to the class frequency. So the total number of frequency in that class divided by the width of the class, width of the class interval. Width means the total length of the class interval. Okay, total length of the class interval. So first we have to calculate a frequency density, then we will form the histogram. So if we take an example for a group frequency distribution, we will see and graph, we will form a graph. So you can see that. Okay, now let's set an example. Let's say there is a interval for the values. Interval for the values is 130 to 130. We'll take 10 to 20 or 10 to 15. Let's say 10 to 15. And the corresponding frequency is, let's say, 15. Okay. 10 to 15. Next, 15 to 20. And the corresponding frequencies is, let's say, 10. 20 to 25. The corresponding frequencies, let's say, 10. This is, let's say, 8. Okay. Next frequency, let's say 30 to 32. 30 to 32 or 30 to 31. 30 to 31. The frequency is, let's say, 5. Next 31 to 40. The frequency is, let's say, 10, say. Okay. So this is a group frequency distribution is given. The class boundary, as there is a this is a continuous variable, continuous frequency distribution, group frequency distribution. So we don't have to form to find the class boundaries. We don't have to form, as the this is the continuous group frequency distribution. As the upper boundary of the this class is 15, and the next class, and the lower boundary of the next class is 15. So this is continuous interval, and this is also 25 to 30. One is missing. Okay, this is 25 to 13. Okay. So the class boundaries. We don't have to find the class boundaries, as this is a continuous distribution, continuous interval. Now class width, we have to find the class width to find the frequency density. Class width. Now this is 10 to 15, which is 6. Okay. This is 15 to 20, which is 6. This is 20 to 25, which is 6. This is 25 to 31, which is 7. And this is 31 to 40, which is 10. Okay. So this is the class width. Now we have to find the frequency density. First frequency density is 15 by 6. Class width divided by corresponding class frequency. Next 10 by 6. Next 8 by 6. Next 5 by 7. Next 10 by 10. Okay. Now 15 by 6 means 2.5. This is 2, 3, 2, 5. That means 1.6. 7. Okay. 8 by 6, this is 2 3 2 4, mane 1 by 3 3. Okay. 5 by 7, this is 0. 0.71, this is 1, okay, these are the frequency density. Now, to form the histogram, so there will be also a 2 direction, one direction represents the class interval, okay, and second direction represents the frequency density of each class, okay. Now, as there are different interval, so first the width of the intervals are different, so this is also these graphs also contains some rectangular figure, so each figure has the different width or different length as there are different class lengths, okay. So the class length, first class length is 10 to 15, okay, this is 10 to 15, so this is 10, this is 15. As this is continuous, so next figure will be 15 to 20, as these two will be same, as the class length is same. Also for the third length, this is 10 20, this is 25. Now for the third length, this will be little larger than the different other three, okay. Next 25 to 31 done, 31 to 40, so this will be this part 31 to 40, okay. So first, now we will maximum is 2, so this is, let's say this is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3, okay, 1 2 3, frequency density. Now for the first interval, the frequency density is 2.5. for the first interval, the frequency density is 2.5, so the height of this rectangular figure will be up to this 2.5, okay. This is 2.5, okay. Now next interval, 15 to 20, has the density 1.67, so this is 1, this is 1.567, that means up to this part, so this is 1.67. now next interval has the density 1.33, so 1.33, this is 5.3, okay, 1.33. next density is 0.71 for the class 15 to 31, so 0.71 up to this part, okay. Next, this is 1.33, this is 0.71, and next is next class has the density 1, so this will be into this, okay, this is 1. So this is the histogram formed for the given group frequency distribution. So to find a group the histogram for a group frequency distribution, we have to find the class width. If the interval is continuous, then we don't have to find the class boundaries. If not, then we have to find the class boundary for each of the following group, okay. And next, then we have to find the frequency density for each classes. So frequency density, we have the formula, class frequency divided by width of the class interval. So in this way, we will find the given find the histogram for a given group frequency distribution, okay. Now for the next part, which is ogive, okay, the next part is ogive. Now this is also a frequency this is also a figure for a frequency distribution, okay. Now this ogive can be used to calculate both for simple frequency distribution and also for group frequency distribution. Okay, so first we will find the ogive for a simple frequency distribution. Next we will find for group frequency distribution. Okay, now first is ogive. To calculate, to form an ogive of a group frequency distribution, we have to use the cumulative frequency for two types, for both types, the less than type and more than type. Okay, so there are two types of ogives. One is ogive for less than type and one is ogive for more than type. For less than type, the cumulative frequency must be calculated as less than type, and for ogive for more than type, the cumulative frequency must calculate it as more than type. Okay, so for an example, so as the example is given, we will use this for a different example. Let the values of the frequency distribution is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for it, and the corresponding frequencies are 3, 5, 7, 4, 2. Okay, so in this part we have to find two types of cumulative frequency. So cumulative frequency for less than type, for less, and cumulative frequency for more than type. Okay, now less than type is 3, then adding that next frequency we will get 8, and 8 plus 7 which will be 15, 15 plus 4 which will be 19, 19 plus 2 which is 10, 21. So total number of observations is 21. And for CF for more than type, the total number of observations first 21, and subtracting it from the next class we will get 21 minus 5 which is 16, 16 minus 7 which will be 9, 9 minus 4 which will be 5, 5 minus 2 which will be 3. Okay, right, 21 minus 5 16, 16 minus 7 9, 9 minus 4 5, 5 minus 2 3. Okay, now the same way we will find the as we formed the frequency polygon, here also we will to first find the ogive for the cumulative frequency less than type, or ogive for the less than type, we will get a total 5 points. Okay, and also there will be another 2 points to make it closed, in a closed graph. Okay, now first we have a graph and this is values and this is frequency, cumulative frequency. So there will be two sides, two direction. One direction contains the values and second direction contains CF. Okay, cumulative frequencies. Okay, so the maximum is 21. So we make it in this form 5, 10, let's say this is 5, this is 5, this is 10, this is 15, this is 20, this is 25. Okay, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So to form ogive for less than type, first values is 1, the corresponding cumulative frequencies is 3. So 1, this will be this point. Okay, Now next is 2, whose corresponding cumulative frequency is less than type is 8. So 2, 8, okay. And next 3 is 15. Next value is 3, the this corresponding frequency is 15. And this, okay. Next corresponding frequencies is next value 4, which is 19. 15 20 19, okay. Next corresponding frequencies for the 5 values 5, 21 21 21 19 21 21 19 21, okay. Now if we add this now here also we will take the 00 point, so this will be adding in this form. And up to this part there will be a parallel line, parallel for this direction, okay, corresponding to the values, parallel to corresponding to the values, okay. So this is the cumulative ogive for the less than type. And now for greater than type, more than type, the first frequency content, for greater than the first frequency content, 21, cumulative frequency 21, so 21, this is 21. Now for 2, the corresponding frequency is 16, 15 to 16. Now for 3, the corresponding cumulative 9, this is 9. The for 4, the cumulative cumulative is 5, and for 5 the cumulative frequency is 3, so this is 3, okay. So here also there will be a parallel line, the last part for the value 0, and the adding of the corresponding points will give a ogive for the more than type. And this is also for we will take the legs value 6 and adding this point, we will get the ogive for the, this is ogive for less than type, this is less than type, and this is ogive for more than type, okay. So in this way we will find the ogive for the continuous simple frequency distribution. In the next class I will just explain the group ogive for the group frequency distribution. That's it for today, okay. So I have given the PDF in the previous class. Now you can study it thoroughly, okay. That's it for today.